In today's video, we are taking eggs prepared in a variety of ways and putting them to the test, seeing how well they stand the freeze-drying process. Guys, Dominic Termine said, try freeze-drying a raw and cooked egg. Well, I think that sounds like an awesome idea, but I think we can actually push that a little bit further. We have a lot of eggs, and I want to try and prepare these in a lot of strange ways, maybe some not so strange, because eggs are actually very well known for freeze-drying very well and keeping that way. I want to push that limit and see just how weird we can make our eggs and see if they're actually going to survive this process. All right, we've got our freeze-dryer all ready to go. We've got our eggs. It's time to cook some of these. Let's start with a few basic eggs. We're going to hard boil a couple of these. Scrambled eggs. That one is ready to go. All right, we've got our three types of cooked eggs, so we're gonna go ahead and get those set up. Then we're gonna add a few more to this tray, so we've got lots of comparisons. Our hard-boiled egg, over easy. And some scrambled, but I want to add a few more. So let's go ahead and add just a raw egg. That's supposed to work really well in the freeze dryer, and I want to put that to the test. Another thing I'm very curious about is just a whole raw egg. And last but not least, we have got three cooked eggs, two raw, but I want to put something else in there. Now I have here a naked egg. Now these are so much fun, you guys, and you can actually make these at home. You'll see that this egg doesn't have a shell anymore. It's almost bouncy. It's still raw and it's still held together. All you need to do is put distilled white vinegar into a cup and drop an egg into it for about 24 hours. Now what's gonna happen is the acetic acid in the vinegar is actually going to eat away at the calcium carbonate of the shell. When that happens, it starts to dissolve away. What you end up with is an egg that looks like this. So you can see here, the acetic acid actually ate away all the calcium carbonate, and now you get this soft, squishy, cracked shell. If you run it under some water and clean it up, you get a naked egg. So let's throw this in with the rest of them, get these freeze drying. All right, so we have let our eggs freeze dry overnight, and I'm pretty sure one of them has exploded, so I want to take a look at that. So let's turn off the machine and see what happened. All right, everything seems to have worked except for our vinegar egg. It's like powdered meringue. That is a disaster. I want to see the footage. I want to know what happened there. All right, so we have three different angles of the GoPros to show just what happened here, and I want to know. Mostly, I'm very confused about what happened to our vinegar egg. There's nothing in between those two shots. It just explodes. My goodness. And then everything just sort of shrinks back down and stays that way. All right, what did the other angles pick up? You can still see that everything's starting to freeze and shrink up. And this is a 2 second difference between these two frames. And that's insane. That thing just exploded. All right, Dominic, we've tried a lot of weird things with these eggs, so let's see what the results are. As you can see, our vinegar egg was just, it's like meringue almost. It's just powder. Here's that soft, rubbery shell that was left, and it, you can see where that split was. These two pieces actually stayed decently intact. Yep, still a very, very strong vinegar smell. All right, this is awesome. This is a freeze-dried round egg yolk, and it actually feels very dense. This is our freeze-dried hard-boiled egg, and it's definitely lighter than an egg should be, but it still feels a lot denser than things you normally find in a freeze dryer. But this egg yolk that was in our vinegar egg is solid. Oh, that's weird. It comes apart in layers. Oh, not center. Whoop. There it goes. Freeze-dried vinegar rotten egg. Cool. Next up is our raw eggs. I don't know if I can peel it, but we're gonna try. That's the coolest. Freeze-dried raw egg. And this also has the consistency of almost a meringue, which is awesome. So can you freeze-dry a solid raw egg? You can. I'm not sure what the purpose would be, but you can do it. Now this was just our raw egg cracked in a bowl and then left. Now I'm going to leave this one for last because I actually want to try a few experiments with this. I want to see if you can reconstitute a raw freeze-dried egg for cooking. So we'll set this one aside. And we're going to look at our freeze-dried cooked eggs. This one's probably the funniest to me. A hard-boiled freeze-dried egg. Like, the other ones are awesome because, yeah, that weighs nothing. This is just over easy, hard egg. Okay, not terrible. That's still edible. I don't know if you'd ever want egg crackers, but you can do it. And I'm actually very curious about the scrambled eggs, because supposedly you can reconstitute those. You throw them in a skillet with some hot water, and you should be able to bring them back to life, so I want to see. But just as a comparison, these are two eggs that I made this morning, and these are our freeze-dried ones. So if you compare these, as far as looks go, they haven't changed nearly as much as some other foods that we've made in the past in this freeze dryer. All right, so everything that's on this tray has been cooked. So even though it's been freeze-dried or anything like that, these are all technically safe. So an egg that was cooked about 10 minutes ago. Regular cooked egg. This monstrosity. Well, it fell apart. It's just crumble. I can't even pick that up. Now, as far as taste goes, it definitely tastes different, but it's hard to put your finger on why. I would almost say it has more flavor, which is interesting because in the past we've noticed that things in the freeze dryer, if you try and reconstitute them, lose a lot of flavor. But even before that, this has a lot more flavor going in than I would have expected. Let's get our hard boiled. It is not wanting to stay together. Oh, okay, that's also interesting. The egg white is just flaking apart, but the egg yolk in this is very resistant. Nope. Okay. Everything else is fine. I do not recommend freeze-drying hard-boiled eggs. The center is still frozen, but the taste is definitely off. That's a little bit strange. Let's see if we can bring those scrambled eggs back to life, and then I'm curious about that raw egg. Supposedly, you can use raw eggs that have been freeze-drying in cooking, just like you can fresh eggs. So I want to try that. Just like reconstituting anything, we're going to add a little bit of water. See if we can turn that into egg. They're getting sort of squishy again. After everything that we've tried in our Harvest Right freeze dryer, this is the best thing that's turned out. This actually tastes just like scrambled eggs. That is awesome that you can do that. All right, let's put this to the test. We're gonna have equal ingredients for our mug cakes. Toss in one freeze-dried egg, one raw egg, and see what happens. So 10 tablespoons of your cake mix. For mug cakes, you don't really need to be that specific. Teaspoon of vegetable oil. Add our eggs. Now for our raw egg, we are going to remove the yolk because we did that for the freeze-dried egg. Seems right. And then for water, I just add water until you get a cake batter consistency. So obviously we're gonna need more water in our freeze-dried egg, but the result should be the same. Much less water in this one. All right, so the first thing that I'm noticing is while they have the same consistency mostly, their water content seems to be about the same now. Our one with the freeze-dried eggs is definitely less tacky, less sticky, and I'm wondering if that's going to affect anything. Regular egg cake mug. Still a little doughy on top, but these mugs apparently top out at about 1 minute for our mug cakes. All right, so we had about the same amount. You can already see how much a mug cake just rises up. So hopefully we'll get the same result with our powdered egg. So that was about 1 minute, so we'll do the same. Oh wow, it actually looks fluffier than our regular egg, but they rose to almost the exact same height. They both have one giant bubble right in the middle. Taste test time. Regular first. Cherry chip cake, which is awesome. Freeze-dried egg, just powdered, not even powdered well, and tossed into a cake. Literally no difference. That is awesome. You can freeze dry your eggs, you don't have to use the egg yolk, you don't even have to powderize it well, and you can cook with it. That is amazing. I am thrilled. Also, I have cake for lunch. Can you freeze dry eggs in any form? Yes, you can. Can you reconstitute them and use them in cooking? You can do that too. Should you freeze dry all types of eggs? Probably not. Harvest Right, thank you so much for letting us use your freeze dryer for these experiments. Guys, if you want to see anything else super weird freeze dried, let us know in the comments below. Guys, that's not all. We've always got more for you to see. That box up at the top will take you to our latest video, and that box at the bottom is what YouTube thinks you should be watching next. Hit this bomb in the middle to subscribe to the club so you never miss out on the fun. Don't forget to ring that bell, and we'll see you in the next one. Talk to you then.